Hello there, Neo Rashi here. Yesterday I made a video showing the top 20 manga of the music soul album. Well, at least it is the album. I should be a little bit better. Anyway, yesterday I made a top 20 manga I discovered in 2021. And since 2020 is the year that actually made me go back into manga full time, I decided maybe it would be a good idea to make a top something for my for the manga I discovered in 2020. So I decided to make a top 15. I didn't discover as many manga in 2020. Oh, the music is reading out. Should be better that way. Yeah, because I started to buy manga in late 2020, in October to be exact. So unlike yesterday, I won't tell you when exactly I discovered these series, because it's all going to be between October and October and December, with like one exception, which was actually in 2019, but I only discovered the anime in 2019 and then went to the manga a year later. Anyway, so let's start with 15th place. Tomo-chan is a Girl. When I saw it on in my manga store, I just looked at the first two pages and I knew it would be like one of those hilarious rom-com. And it's also one of the first rom-com I actually finished. I read all 8 volumes. It's a pretty good rom-com. Not the best, but definitely enjoyable. 14th place goes to Rent-A-Girlfriend. I actually don't know why I bought this. I just heard about it. And when I saw volume 1 and 2 and 3 at my manga store, I just rolled with it and bought it, and I liked it. There are some places where it like gets boring, but overall the story is okay. I like most of the character, and even the character I don't like, they actually give some decent story. So that's why I like it, even though there are parts that do get boring. Next is the only French manga in this slot, and it kind of pisses me off because Seven Seas announced like a week ago that they would be releasing it in English. Yokohama Kaidashi Kiku. I never read the French books. I have volume 1 through 4, but I've actually read 1 through 4 in Scan's website. So yeah, it's gonna... I don't know why I haven't read them yet. It's a seriously good yashike. It's like, I kind of like, in a way, like Girls Last Door, where it's a yashike that takes place like in a post-apocalyptic world. Although Yokohama Kaidashi Kiku is definitely not as dark. I know Girls Last Door is definitely darker than Yokohama Kaidashi. Yokohama is definitely more wholesome. Next would be Fractime, which is actually my first Yuri manga. I decided, like, one day, I told my ex, she was still my girlfriend back then, like, hey, I want to try a Yuri. And she was like, oh, that would be nice. So, yeah, you should try it then. I went to my manga store like a day or two after, and I found this and saw that there was only 2 volumes, and this book includes both volumes. So yeah, I took it, read it, and loved it. It's a shame that it only has 2 volumes though, because I would definitely have liked there to be more volumes. Alright, next is... Ozaki-chan Wants to Hang Out. I mainly like this one. I bought this one because even though I'm not in Two Girls with Huge Boobs, I did find Uzaki to be quite cute. Well, her face at least. And I actually watched the anime before reading this, and I really liked it. So that's what led me to get a manga. And Volume 3 was a massive pain in the ass to get. Just to find a copy, I waited like 2 or 3 weeks before I could find a copy of Volume 3. And from there, it took another 2 weeks before I get it because I had to import it from the UK. Now it's easier to find, but back then, it definitely was a pain in the ass. For the next book, Volume 7 was the one that was being a pain in the ass to get. Citrus, and let's count Citrus Plus at the same time since it's a sequel and not a spin-off. This was my first Yuri anime. And when I watched anime, Matsuri, like the main antagonist of like Volume 3 of the manga and episode 7 to 9 of the anime, actually left me a like sour taste in my mouth because of what she did. And while she does stop her evil ways, you can say that, and do become on friendly terms with Yuzu and Mei afterwards, starting episode 10, she doesn't really redeem herself before Volume 7, so I know a lot of people who only watch the anime actually hated Matsuri, and while I can understand people not forgiving her completely for what she did, she definitely does get better starting like Volume 6 or 7 in the manga. So, people who only watch the anime, definitely read the manga, it's actually worth it. The anime only covers the first 4 volumes anyway, out of 10 volumes of the main series, and like three or four more for the sequel. All right, so we're down to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, apparently, if I count it right. That would be Teasing Master Takagi-san. This is the anime that I mentioned I discovered in 2019, but the reason I still consider it a series that I discovered in 2020 is because, well, first, I actually watched season 2 because season 1 is not on Netflix and season 2 is on Netflix, and that's what I watched. And I discovered both season 1 and the manga in 2020. And back when I tried Teasing Master Takagi-san, I wasn't really back into anime. I tried three animes: Teasing Master Takagi-san, which I kind of liked, but now I love it. The other two were Sword Art Online, which I didn't dislike, but I definitely didn't like all that much, and Seven Deadly Sins, which I definitely hate. I gave up after 20 episodes. I didn't went further than like the first season. But yeah, Teasing Master Takagi-san was one of the first anime Blu-ray I bought, and not quite the first manga I bought in 2020, but like still among the first. Next is Fly Me to the Moon, and I got this one because basically what I heard online, like I heard re I watched read review online and saw that Naza and Tsukasa get married on the first volume. And actually, this picture is also something that got me interested. And I really like the art style. I like even Naza's design. Like, not just Tsukasa, even the guys in this series have great design, so I really like it. For the next one, I don't think it's gonna need any introduction because it's probably one of the most famous Yuri out there. Bloom Into You. As I said, I'm not going to introduce this one. Everyone knows about Bloom Into You. It's really super popular. It's definitely in the West, it's probably the most popular Yuri manga of all times. And I mainly took it because it was popular, but I ended up really liking it as well. So yeah, I haven't watched the anime yet, but I did read a whole series and the light novel. Next is Our Wonderful Days, which I decided to read because I heard it was super chill, no drama, and it is true. It's actually a Yuri slash Yashike. But I didn't realize it was a Yashike until January 2021, because that's when I really went hard on Yashike. So yeah, it's a short series, 3 volumes only. The actual romance doesn't show up until the end of the series. Like, both girl confesses to each other really late into the series, and before that, it's really just like these two girls and their two friends hanging out together, having fun. There's no drama whatsoever. The only hint of drama is like on a flashback or something. Other than that, super chill series. Now, on the other side of the, I wouldn't say completely on the other side of the spectrum, but it's still something that's really different. We Never Learn is fifth place. I bought it for the, mostly for the etchiness, because I'm still kind of a perv. Like, I wouldn't go, like, get Rule 34 of this kind of book, especially since, like, three of the five girls are, like, not 18. So, yeah, I ended up really liking the story. I only read up to volume 15 so far, but I'm really liking the story. My favorite character is definitely Fumino, like this girl, a girl with the blue hair. But I like all five of them. Like, even the one I like the least, I still like her. Fourth place goes to not a manga, but a light novel. It's my first light novel. Adachi Shimamura. This is the series that actually got me into light novel. Now I have, if you watch my monthly videos, well, now it's monthly, but before that it was like every 2 or 3 weeks. You see that I have a growing collection of light novels, but this is a series that really got me to light novel. Nowadays, I wouldn't say it's my favorite light novel. I would probably even say it's not my favorite Yuri light novel. For light novel, I strangely prefer the action-packed one, like Roll Over and Die and The Executioner and A Way of Life. But this is still a very worthy series, and I'm looking forward to read the rest. I've read up to volume 7 in physical format and up to volume 9 in scans websites. Third place goes to Komi Can Communicate. The reason for this is, like I said yesterday, I like shy girls. And when I learned about this series, I went online, read the first few chapters, and I loved it. So I ordered all 9 volumes that were out at the time. And now it's a series I really like, and I hope the series will end. I know some people don't like when series are too long, and I'm actually among those people, but this and Laid Back Camp are two series that I'm definitely not looking forward to handling. Second place goes to Kaze-san and Yamada, and the reason for this is because the art style is cute. I really like how the story is usually chill, and even when there's drama, it's almost always resolved. Sometimes not even at the end of the volume. The series never end with a cliffhanger. The volumes never end with a cliffhanger. Every time something, like every time shits comes up, it's fixed by the end of the book. So that's one of the reasons I really like this series. Oh, and also I'm counting the sequel series Kaze-san and Yamada at the same time. First place goes to a new game, and I have several reasons for putting this in first place. First, I really like the character. Aoba is definitely my favorite character of all times, even though there's a couple manga I like more than new game, like Laid Back Camp and Nonon Diary. It's a video game, like based on video games, because it takes place in the video game industry, and I'm a gamer, so this is definitely a huge plus. Like, I have a couple of rom-com, Yuri rom-com, not Yuri, sorry, video game based, a theme rom-com that I really like, and you thought there's another girl online and gamers. So yeah. Also, like yesterday, I have something to show you. Yesterday with Laid Back Camp, I told you about the games I bought, but I think I did worse for for new game, because I have the PS Vita game, a new game, a challenge stage, but you can see it's still sealed. The reason for this, I also have the limited edition of the same game on the same console. I actually bought this one for about $120, tax and shipping included. But before it even arrived, I saw a fairly priced copy of the limited edition, which was brand new. Now it's open and. But yeah. But with tax and shipping and import fees, this one cost me a bit over $300. So while I spent over over $300 for Laid Back Camp, with the, I show you yesterday, you can actually see I put the Wii copy here and the PS4 copy here. I said Wii, but Switch. But for new game, almost 400. Well, probably over 400, almost close to 450 for these two copies. And even though it's a pretty crappy game, it's a visual novel, but that's plagued with RNG stuff. That's fucking sucks. It's a really bad game, but I still like it because it's new game. Anyway, that was it. Hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.